Hello everyone, welcome to my tutorial series on Docker. So in the last chapter we ran our first Docker container using the docker run command. So in this chapter we are going to explore our container a bit more. So let's say we want to see what all the containers are running on our machine. So we will use docker ps command. Docker ps tells us all the containers that are in running state on our machine. So this command gives us the container ID. It gives us the name of the image. The command that is being executed inside the container, and also tells when the container was created and what is the current status of the container. It also gives us the port mapping between the host machine and the Docker container, and at large it gives us the name of the container. So Docker PS gives us the information about the running containers only, and if we want to see all the containers that are present on our machine, we can use docker ps hyphen a command. So here we can see that we are having a container named busybox, the image of the busybox, and the is it in the exit state. So now we want to see the logs generated from a particular container. So we will use docker ps to get the ID of the container, and we will use docker logs command. So docker logs along with the container ID or the name gives us the logs that are being generated, all the tail of the logs that are generated from the container. We can use docker logs along with the hyphen f flag. So hyphen f stands for follow. So if we use docker logs hyphen f along with the container ID, we can see the tail of the logs, continuous tail of the logs. So if we go ahead to the browser and refresh the page and we come back, we can see the log are getting refreshed on our terminal. So we will press Ctrl C to exit from that, and now let's explore a bit more about our container. So let's say we want to see what's actually inside our container. So for that we will use docker exec command. So firstly we will look at the container ID using docker ps. We will copy the container ID, and it will use docker exec hyphen it, the ID of the container and sh. So docker exec is used to run a command inside the container, and here we are asking it to attach a interactive terminal to our container. This is the ID of the container, and at last this is the command that we want to run inside the container. The command is sh. So on pressing enter here, we will observe that the prompt is changed here. So earlier, this is because we are inside our container now. So earlier we were on our host machine and the prompt was this, and now we are inside our container and the prompt has been changed. Okay, so after coming inside the container, we will run few command. We will run apt get update, and once it's done, we will run apt install vim. So we will run apt get update to update the repositories on our container, on the OS of the container, and apt get install vim. Update command. So we use apt get install vim to install a vi editor on our machine. So as the docker containers are delivered to us in a bare minimum way, so that they contain only the bare minimum thing required to run our code. So they don't contain any video driver or the audio driver or the editor. So that's why we are installing vi editor, and we will check whether the vi editor is installed properly using the vi command here, and we can see yes, the editor has been successfully installed. So now we will change our directory to the root directory of the nginx. So the root directory is user share nginx html. So here we will see a file index.html. So index.html is the default file that is being served to our clients by the nginx. So we will go and make some edits using the vi editor. So we will change the line welcome to nginx to welcome to docker tutorial, welcome to docker tutorial, and we will save the file. And now we will restart the Nginx using nginx-s reload command. Now if we go to the browser again and refresh it, we will see the content has been changed here. Earlier it was welcome to Nginx and now it's welcome to Docker tutorial. So we will type exit to exit our container and now we are back to our host machine. So let's explore a bit more of our Docker commands. So we will write docker ps to get the information of all the containers. And we will copy the container ID. So first command is docker container diff. So if we want to see what all the changes are done inside our container, we will use docker container diff. And here we will search index.html. And here we can see the content of the index.html has been changed. Okay, let's continue. So we will use docker ps to get the information of the containers and we can see the name of the container is web. We will use docker rename command. Docker rename old name followed by the new name. So we are renaming web with the web name. And now if we run docker ps, we will see that the name of the container has been changed. So there is docker restart command that is used to restart a particular container. So if we can see the ID or the name of the container over here, that means the command is successfully executed. Yes, we can see the name. And similar is docker stop command, which is used to stop a particular container. So docker stop the name of the container. And we can see the name of the container here. So this means the command docker container has been stopped. And if we run docker ps here, so we can see that no container is in running state and docker ps-a will show that the Nginx container is in the exited state. So let's say we want to delete a particular container, so we will remove using docker rm command. So even if the container has been removed from the machine, the images still remain on our machine. So we will use docker images command to get the information of all the images that are existing on our machine. So we will write docker images and we can see we have a Nginx and busybox image existing on our machine. We can use docker image rm to delete a particular image from our machine. So docker image rm and the name of them or the ID of them particular image. So here we can see that the command is executed and if we type docker images again, we will see that the Nginx image has been removed. Okay, so let's review all the commands once again. We use docker run to run a particular container if we are having the image of the container, and docker ps is used to see all the containers running on our machine. ps-a is used to see all the containers that are existing on our machine. Docker logs is used to get the logs generated from our particular machine, and docker exec is used to execute a particular command inside our machine, inside a container. Similarly, docker rename is used to rename. Docker stop is to stop a container. Docker restart is to restart a particular container, and docker rm with the container ID to remove a particular container from our machine. Docker images to see all the images that are existing on our machine. And at last, docker images rm with the image ID to delete a particular image from our machine.